Thank you. Yeah. Metabula Ramadim.
Are you the Peter of God?
Metabula Ramadim.
Are you the Peter of God?
Or not the Metabule?
Then if you are happy,
or our Ilocamoca, Izamakata, well,
it means everything is going with God's love.
Amen. And without a waste of time, let us open our Bible. Amen.
Amen.
Let us open our Bible in the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter
22.
Amen. Genesis chapter
22. Got it.
Let us read in verse 7. Genesis 22, verse 7. You are not going to quote it, Ebale Agatelaye. And Isaac spoke unto Abraham his father and said, My father. And he said, Here I am, my son. And he said, Behold the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering? Amen. 8. And Abraham said, My son, God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering. So they went both of them together. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord God Almighty, Father Lord Jesus Christ, I'm just a man who needs you, Lord Jesus Christ. Father Lord God, as I'm here, Father Lord God, with Brother Mvengu, Lord Jesus Christ, may you help us, Lord Jesus Christ. May you strengthen us, Lord Jesus Christ. For we know, Lord God, the devil, Lord Jesus Christ, is always fighting, Lord God.
Yes.
Lord God, we say, Lord Jesus Christ, may your blood, Lord God, cover us this, Lord God, this morning, in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And
God.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Here we read, amen. We heard about the man called Abraham.
Amen.
Who God told him, that take thy son, your only son, the one whom you love.
Amen.
God said unto Abraham, take thy son, whom thou lovest, and make a sacrifice. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The title for today is the attitude of the people that brings the result.
Amen.
Amen. Is the attitude of the people that brings the result. Amen. Your attitude towards God's word.
Amen.
Is the church here? It will be your attitude for today. For God to come down. God to come down. Amen. It will be your attitude, the church today. For God to come down. Or where is the church? Are you sleeping? It will be your attitude to bring God down today. Amen.
Amen.
Isaac asked the father. I see everything is here. But where is the lamb? Amen.
Amen.
Where is the lamb?
Amen.
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 We should ask ourselves today. The promises are here in the Bible. But where is God today? Where is the church?
Amen.
We want to see God today. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Last week we spoke. When God was saying,
Amen.
Amen. He said unto Gideon, go with this thy might. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Today, it's your attitude that will bring God today. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
In the book of John chapter 2.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
They were in a marriage. Amen.
Amen.
And then it happened that the wine was finished. Amen. In verse 3. It reads as
follows.
He said, when they wanted wine, when they wanted wine, the mother of Jesus, amen,
amen,
said unto him, they have no wine.
Oh, are we no Jesu abana wine?
Amen. Jesus said unto her,
Jesu amu araba an.
Woman,
musali,
what have I to do with thee?
Kinalin kawena.
My hour is not yet.
Orayaka I so feet.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, praise the Lord.
Amen.
His mother said unto the servants, whatsoever he said unto you, do it. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, church.
Amen.
It's your attitude. So Jesus said to the mother, amen, my hour has not yet come. But the mother went to the servants.
Amen.
And he said to them, whatsoever he said, he shall say unto you, do it. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's your attitude.
Amen.
Is the church here today?
Yes.
Okay, if the church is here, then let us rejoice. Because the atmosphere, your attitude will bring the result today. It's your attitude that will bring the result in your life. It's your attitude that will bring the result today. Amen.
Amen.
There was a man by the name William St. Moore.
William St. Moore.
When he saw what was happening in the church, he said, no. God didn't promise us the things. We must see God in the church. What did he do? He went. Amen. And then he rented a place somewhere in Azusa Street. In the upper room. And then they prayed. And prayed. Until God comes down. It's your attitude that will bring the result. Oh, where is the church? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. I once heard of a story. Amen. Of a certain girl and his younger brother. This young girl, she was outside with the brother. Busy playing. And then it happened that they were hungry. And then the sister said to the younger brother, go and ask mom for bread for bread and jam. Amen.
Amen.
And then the younger brother went and came back.
Abuya.
And then when he was coming back, he didn't have that bread and jam. And the sister asked, where is the bread and jam? Amen.
Amen.
Where is the bread and jam? And the
younger
brother said, mommy refused to give me. Amen.
Amen.
And the younger sister said again, go back and ask mom to give us that bread and jam because we are hungry. The brother went back and came back. No bread and jam. And the sister asked, where is that bread and jam? And the brother said, Mama refused.
Make one.
And the sister said, let me go. And I will bring that jam, that bread and jam. Amen.
Amen.
The sister went. When she comes back, she was holding a bread and jam. And the younger brother was confused. What's happening? Because I went there. Mama refused. But my sister went and came back with that bread and jam. What happened? It was the attitude. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
When the brother asked the sister, how did you do it? The sister said, I asked. She refused. And I cried. I said, I will not go back until I receive that bread and jam. That brings the result.
I never
praise Amen. It was the attitude. He said, daughter, I respect you as a man of science. But I went and I prayed and I prayed and the Holy Spirit came down and the Holy Spirit said that daughter will leave. What happened? It was the attitude of the old man. Oh, what is your attitude today towards every promise of God? Amen. What is your attitude? Oh, you think God is quiet towards you? Amen. You think God is quiet? It's the attitude. Amen. It is the attitude. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Your attitude. Your attitude. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. When we read in the book of Mark. Amen. Praise the Lord. In the book of Mark. When they were going to crucify Jesus. Amen. There's something that happened there. Amen. Amen. People created an atmosphere that we must crucify this Jesus. And Pilate asked, what did he do wrong? They said, no, we want to crucify him. It was the atmosphere that made him that Jesus should go and be crucified. Amen. Praise the Lord. It was the attitude of the people around you. Amen. When you read in the book of John chapter 3. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. The elders of the church. They knew who is Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But they didn't want people to know that they know. And then one day, there was a man by the name of Nicodemus. Praise the Lord. The Bible said Nicodemus went there by night to see Jesus. Amen. And said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art the teacher that comes from God. He said, we know. Amen.
Amen.
But their attitude towards him, it made them to go by night. Because they look at the people around them. Amen. So today, it will be your attitude. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So what Brother Brennan gave us a story.
Brother Brennan, what is that story?
Amen.
Amen.
About a certain shepherd.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Who was having the sheep. And one of the sheep didn't behave very well. The attitude of that sheep. Amen.
Amen.
Or of that lamb was not very well. And the shepherd saw that this attitude. Of this lamb is not good. Amen.
Amen.
And the shepherd has a good shepherd. He had to break one of the leg of this lamb because of the attitude of this sheep. He broke one of the legs because of the attitude. He broke one of the legs. Amen.
Amen.
And then they said they saw him carrying one of those carrying that lamb. And they asked this man, what happened to this lamb? He said, I broke one of the legs. You should that if you are a cruel person. How could you do that? Should God break one of your legs? Should God break one of your legs? So that you can listen to him. The attitude of this lamb was not good. And a good shepherd. So that lions will kill this one. So he broke one of the legs. So that he can feed this lamb with his own hand. It's your attitude that will bring the result. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Is the church of God still here?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Okay? Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Okay, Prophet Ori. Now you've got to create an atmosphere. And your faith will do it. They were all in the upper room with in the upper room with one accord. Amen. In one accord. One mind. One spirit. Amen. They were in one accord. They created an atmosphere. Why don't we create that atmosphere today? Because when the atmosphere is right, God will come down. When the atmosphere is right, God will come down. Praise the Lord. What happened when they were in one accord? Suddenly they come. Amen. Suddenly there come from heaven a sound of a rushing mighty wind. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The atmosphere was right. And the prophet said, it takes the atmosphere to do anything. Oh, where is the church today? Why don't we be in one accord? So now we can see Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
We want to see
Jesus.
Let us create the atmosphere. If we want to see this
Jesus,
let us create the atmosphere.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
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 Let us create the atmosphere.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Brother Brent sometimes spoke about the chickens. He said, it's the atmosphere that brings the result. Amen.
Amen.
He said, when you take an egg,
amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Okay, let me just read it. You know, the regular procedure to hatch chickens is to put them after the hen. But get the egg in the right atmosphere. It will hatch anyhow. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So let us create this atmosphere. Amen.
Amen.
That God will come down today. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Oh, praise the Lord. Are you tired? Children of God. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
It is the atmosphere.
Amen.
Amen. It's the atmosphere that will take God down today.
But
let us have a right, a mental attitude towards every promise of God. Today. Amen.
Amen.
Our problems is that we postpone things. Oh, maybe God will answer me tomorrow. Maybe God will answer me next week. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. It's your attitude today.
That will
bring
this.
Amen. Amen. There was another story. Amen. That I heard. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
About a certain man. A certain poor man. Amen.
Amen.
Who once went to a bank.
Oh, ile aya banke.
And then he said to the tellers.
Hafika banking abulela li okungo babereki bamo.
Amen. He said to this person, I want to see the manager.
Kinyaka ubona manager.
Amen.
Amen.
And the man looked at that man.
Munayo alibelela munayo.
This man was so poor.
I munayo all daily mudidi.
Amen. Yeah. And then he wants to see the manager.
We are no big animodidi. Unyaka ubona manager wali filole.
Amen.
Amen.
And he said, man, why don't you speak to me?
Now I know somebody.
I said, no, no, I want to see the manager.
Ali, awa, kinyaka ubona mulaudi wa banka.
Amen.
He said, okay, I'll take you to the manager.
Ali kitawisa umulaudi.
Amen.
Amen.
His attitude.
My carrel or my charo ahan.
Meet this person.
I had either
to allow him to see the manager. Your attitude.
My charo ahan.
Counts a lot today.
Amen. Amen.
This man went to the manager of the bank. He said to the manager, I want the 100,000 that you promised me. And then the manager looked at him. Who are you? He said, I'm the man whom you promised
100,000.
God promised us today. That whatever that you ask,
yes,
I will give it unto you. And then this man, the manager, said, what proof do you have that I will give you that I promise you that
100,000?
Amen. What proof do you have? And this man take his hand to his pocket, and then he bring forth a piece of paper. Amen. He said, here is the proof. You wrote here that any day that I will be in need of 100,000 and I come to this bank, you will give it to me.
Amen.
And it was signed by the manager himself. Amen.
Amen.
And the man looked at that paper. They said, the manager said, this should be long time ago. And then he said to the employee, take this man and give him that 100,000. Why? It was written that in one day you will be in need. 100,000, I will give it to you. So when you read your Bible, God wrote that if you are in need of anything, when you are in need of anything, when you will ask anything, and you come to me, God said, I will give it unto you. Oh, praise the Lord. It's your attitude. God will
Where is the church today? Is your attitude that will bring God down today?
Amen.
Who's my brother? I think the church is sleeping.
No.
After this great sermon. Amen. Of what God can do to you. Let us go and sit down. Amen.
Amen.
Because their attitude will bring the results. Where is the church? Where is the Lord? It's your attitude. It's your attitude now that will bring the results. You have the power. Oh, there is this power in a believer that can shake the whole world. There is this power in a believer. The Holy Spirit is here. It takes the attitude now to receive whatever that you want. It takes your attitude. The atmosphere is right. But your attitude towards God's promise will bring the results. Amen. When Mary was told, this is not yet my time, she didn't quit. She didn't quit. She went to the servant and said, whatever that he said, do it. Do it. Whatever that he said, do it. It doesn't matter if it looks crazy, but when God said, do something, do it. When they ask, why don't you ask? When he said the sick will recover, why don't you believe it? Why do you still stay there and cry? Amen. Why do you stay there and cry? Why do you stay there? And be saying, can God hear me? Can God hear me? Why do you cry? When there is this power that asks anything. Anything. Jesus said, I will do it. You are not going to do it, my brother, my sister. So why do you take it out yourself? As if you are going to do something. Your duty is to create an atmosphere. Is to have a right mental attitude. That's the only thing you have to do. And believe that God is going to do it. Praise the Lord. Realize who you are. Realize who you are. You are a child of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. There was a woman in the Bible who was sick for 12 years. Amen. For 12 years. Sick. But one day, in her own heart, she told herself, oh, where's the church? If I can touch, will be healed. It's the attitude. It was the attitude of that woman that bringeth the result. She was healed immediately. The woman didn't even speak to Jesus. She didn't even ask Jesus, what should I do? Jesus told her something. That if only I can touch, something will happen. After 12 years, spending money to the doctors. But one day, she saw this man called Jesus. She believed.
Amen.
That if only.
Amen.
Amen. She believed it. And she had the result. Why don't you have the result today? It's your attitude.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord.
Amen.
In closing, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Brother Branham speaks about a man.
Brother Branham kubulela ka motho.
A young man.
Oh, liswana le.
Amen. This young man,
liswana leo,
was a son of a king.
Nelili murwa khosh.
Amen.
Amen.
The young man was a slave in a far
country.
Amen.
Amen.
This young man is a slave. Eating with other slaves. Living like a slave. Acting like one of them. One day he remembered. I'm a son of a king. Though I am a slave here, but where I come from, my father is a king. Are you not sons and daughters of the king? This young man remembered where he comes from. Praise the Lord. In the book of Proverbs, it is written, amen, that God created us before his works of old. Solomon said, it's like I was with him, saying those things with him. When he was a let there be, he said, I was with him. As if I was saying those things with him. That Paul came.
Paul,
he said,
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Where is the church?
Paul
said,
Paul,
we were chosen in Christ before the foundations of the world. Oh, brother, sister, we were chosen before the foundations of the world. Oh, we were there with him. Where is the church today? So this young man,
this one,
after remembering who he is, he said, I'm a son of a king. Oh, I will live like one. So I'm a slave, but I'm a son of a king. Amen. He started acting like one. He started eating like one. Eating with them. Eating with them in the same basket, but eating like a son of a king. His body started to change. Amen. His behavior started to change. The way he reacted to our things started to change. Until some of the slave masters who wants to do a slave exchange or buy slaves, and this slave, his master, he said, is this man a slave? Because it's different from them. Does this man eat from the same basket? Same food. Same food. He said yes. I treat him like all of them. But this man, where he comes from, his father is a king. So he conducted himself like a son of a king. He created the atmosphere. His attitude was of a son of a king. The body couldn't do anything. His body couldn't do anything because of his atmosphere. Amen. He contacted reacted himself as a son of a king. So his body reacted and showed him to made him to be different. Not because he eat different food. His body changed. His body changed. His behavior changed. Why? He created, there was this atmosphere around him. He created an atmosphere. His attitude created this atmosphere around him. His body couldn't resist it. But to be fresh.
Fresh.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. It was the attitude. What is your attitude today? On this world. On this world. What is your attitude? Oh, brother, sister. Remember who is your father. Get your attitude. Show who is your father. Then you will see what will happen in your life. Something will happen. You don't have to force it. You don't have to force it. But it will happen. But you have to remember who is your father. And your attitude. And your attitude. And your attitude will show who is your father. And when people look at you, they will see an ambassador of heaven.
Amen.
How will that be? Because you will remember who is your father. And your attitude. And your attitude will be of a son and a daughter of a king. And you will walk like one. And you will behave like one. And you will eat like one. Oh, praise God. Who is your father today? If only you know him. Oh, something will happen in your life. Something will happen in your life. Your attitude will change. Oh, your behavior. Amen. Will be different. The way you see things will change.
Amen.
I listened to a man one day. He said, I was a salesman. I used to complain. When it's raining, I complain. When it's not raining, I complain. Amen. When it's sunny outside, I was complaining. Now today it's hot. He said, as a salesman, I stopped complaining and realized that in each and every season there is an opportunity.
Amen.
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 He said, I realized that. Amen. That in each and every season, there's this opportunity. And in the Bible, it is written. In the Bible, it is written. Amen. In the book of James, he said, rejoice when he fall into diverse temptations. Amen. Rejoice. Why will you rejoice when you are sick? Because there's a God in you. Oh, where is the church of God? There's this God in you. He said, rejoice. When you fall into diverse temptations, when you are in different seasons, rejoice. Amen.
Amen.
It's your attitude.
Give my child,
oh, when you are busy, they cry. Oh, I'm sick. Oh, please. Oh. I'm sick. Not praying. Not creating an atmosphere. With that attitude, the demons will dance on your board.
Man, with
that attitude, the demons will rejoice when he falls into diverse temptations. Create an atmosphere of joy.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now we are closing. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
It's your attitude
that
will bring the results.
Amen.
When you are in trials and temptations,
it's
your attitude towards that problem that will bring the result.
Amen.
Amen. I heard a story one time
about a man
and his daughter. Amen. There was a flood where they are going. Amen. As they were busy, the father was busy driving. And then they reached a place where the storm started. And then the father said to the daughter, come and drive. Amen.
Amen.
When you think you are alone, you're not alone. God is there.
Yeah.
So this man allowed this daughter to drive.
As
the daughter was busy driving, the daughter was busy. She was busy complaining. Father, look at this. Other people have parked their cars outside. Why don't we do the same thing? Father, please, why don't you come and drive? Father, the father said, drive.
Okay.
And he said, why don't we just park along the road? His
father
said, no, just drive. And as they were busy driving, There were a lot of things along the road that were happening. Trees fall down along the road. They were blocking the road. But the father said to the daughter, keep on driving. Keep on driving. The daughter was busy complaining. The father said, keep on driving. Keep on driving. And they reached the point where there was no storm anymore. The father said, then now come out. Come here. Look at where we come from. What is happening? The daughter said, I see a storm. I see some lights. And the father said to the daughter, you see, if you have stopped, we were going to be inside this storm. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
If you have stopped along the way, we were going to be inside this storm. But as you are busy praying and praying and saying, God, I'm in this trouble. God, I need you. Keep on pushing. Keep on pushing. Keep on pushing.
Push.
And keep pushing. You need an atmosphere around you. When you look back and you see another sister or brother crying, oh, you will say to him, oh, keep on pushing. Oh, keep on pushing. Why? It was the attitude of the father towards the daughter. But keep on pushing. Amen. It's your attitude today. If you are sick, your attitude towards that sickness will bring the result. If you stop and say, oh, I am sick. Oh, you know me. It will be there. But if you keep on pushing and say, I am healed through Christ, I am healed by the stripes of Christ, something will happen. Amen. Oh, praise the Lord. Yes, Brother Obias is coming. Brother Brennan told us about a man who was blind. This man, he went to a prayer line.
The next thing, the man came back as a blind man holding a stick. And Brother Branham said, I know you. I pray for you. This man said, but I'm still blind. Brother Branham said, go and say, I am healed. Amen. And the attitude of this blind man changed. Holding a stick, telling people that he can see. People were busy laughing. What is this blind man saying? But his attitude, changed. Changed. He said, I can see. People busy laughing. Because when you are sick, and people are looking at you, and you are telling them that you have been healed, they will laugh at you. And this man said, I can see. One day he went to a saloon. When he was there, holding a stick, he said to this man, amen. He said to him, man, I can see. I'm here to cut my hair. Holding a stick, telling this man that I can see.
Amen.
And then this man was looking at him. And this blind man was praising God that I can see. But yet he was blind. Something happened. Something happened in that saloon. That blind man, his eyes were opened. And then he ran out of the saloon. Telling people that I can see. It's your attitude. You are busy telling people, oh, this is my sickness. Oh, this is a family thing. It will be there because of your attitude. Oh, you know, Mama, this sickness started with my grandfather. You are busy praising that demon. No, brother, you don't understand. This is a family thing. Are you not a family of God? Is your father God sick? It's a question. Is your father the king sick? Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
If you think it's yours, then we will leave you with it. Because it's yours. It's your attitude to what that sickness. That is why it's still there. Because it's yours. But if it's not yours and it's not of God, it must be moved in Jesus' name. Because it's not yours and it's not of God, and you are the temple of the living God. And Jesus said, I am my Father who will be in you until the end of the world. So if God is in you, that demon must move. Because God cannot sit in the same house with demons. God is the light. When it's dark here, we switch on the light and darkness run away. It's your attitude. Praise the Lord. Oh, my brother is coming. It's your attitude. You are busy the crying. And say you are sick. It's your attitude that will destroy that demon. Create an atmosphere that will let God come down and heal. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. He finished too quick, man. Do you feel like it? Do you want to go home? No, this is wonderful. So I say, go in this thy power. You are going to defeat your enemies. in this thy power. You may say, I'm too weak. I can't do anything. I just repented. It's not long since I've received the message. I don't have an office. But I say to you, go in this thy power. That power, that little power, is enough to shake the kingdom of the devil.
Amen.
You don't look for a lot of power. For it's not by power nor by might. It's by his spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, it reminds me, in the scriptures, there is this man, Naaman. How many remembers Naaman? That general that was having leprosy. He was a general, a great man, but he was leprosy. A leprosy is a sign of a curse.
Yeah.
It was a sickness, but it's a sign of a curse. So there was a maid in Israel. He spoke to this general and said, there in Israel, there's a God that saves. There's a God that heals. Do you know that Israel types the spiritual church today?
Amen.
There is the message. There is a God that can wake up the dead, that can heal the sick, that can open the blind. And he said, why don't you go and try? So the king of Syria wrote a letter to the king of Israel and he said, I'm sending my general. My son to you, he has got leprosy. May you recover him. And the king of Israel was angry with that letter. But Naaman came with the chariots and horses and his servants with much blessings to the king, to Elisha. And Elisha was sitting in his house. Then Naaman came and stood at the door of Elisha. I want to show you attitude that Brandon was talking about. Then Elisha did not come out of the house. He spoke while he was sitting in his house and said, Naaman, go and wash in Jordan 7 times and your skin shall be clean and be like that of a baby. But Naaman didn't like that. You know what Naaman said? He said, I thought Elisha is going to come out and stand before me and call in the name of his God and touch where my body, where I have got leprosy, and do something. But now he tells me that I should go and worship them in Jordan 7 times. There in Abana, there are rivers in Damascus there. Abana and Pharpar, there are rivers with more cleaner water than this one of Israel. Why can't I go there and wash? And the Bible says, Naaman went away. Look at the attitude of Naaman. He came to the man of God, but he came with the wrong attitude.
Yeah.
Until one of his servants came to Naaman and said, my Lord, my Father, if the man of God had told you to do some greater thing, wouldn't you have done that? What about this one of just going to the river and wash 7 times? Then he hearkened unto the voice of his servant and went to the river and he dipped himself 7 times. When he came out, the Bible says his skin was like that of a baby. You know you love to touch babies. No, babies have got nice skin, soft.
Amen.
The Bible says the skin of the baby was like Naaman was like that of the baby. He was so clean. And he went back to Elijah and said, I'm sorry. May you take the blessing that I've brought in. Elijah says, I won't take it. You come to me with the wrong attitude. attitude is very important. But most of the time we've got the wrong attitude. If I come to you and say, sister, can you help us clean the chairs? Look at your face. There's something that's rising from within you. Why me? Just cleaning a chair, you say, why me? You're not cleaning for me. You're cleaning for the Lord. This is the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Just asking you to do some small things. A sister can come to another sister. Sister, why don't you help us to do this? See, there is something that just starts raising. Why did she come to me? Why did she go to that other one? Look at that kind of attitude. That person is a Christian. He says, I'm a believer. What is your attitude? And we are praying to God every day, saying, Lord, I need this. Lord, bless me with this. God is not going to bless you with nothing. Why? Because of your attitude. Even your special song, you won't receive it. Because you've got wrong attitude. I was reading some of what the prophet says. You know, if a sister, sisters, you know, they love to dress nice and, you know, it's a good, it's a beautiful thing. It's good. And the prophet says, I love to see sister dress neat, nice, very good. But if you buy a dress or something and it dress so that you can feel, he said, imagine, he said, pride, there's this pride that when you dress, you feel like, hey, it's me. And the prophet said, that's the wrong attitude.
Yeah. Amen.
We don't dress to be seen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm not preaching much. I'm just calling you, Lord. You know, you finish so quick. I'm just commenting. We already finished. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me read you something. This is what the prophet says. I will love the Lord.
Amen.
Believe it now, this 1951. The prophet says, it's your attitude toward the divine gift of God which determines what you're going to, what's going to happen. And he said, always, always, your attitude toward the divine gift of God will determine what's going to happen. Whether you are going to be healed or you are going to go out the same way. Your attitude. He said, always, not sometimes, but always, what is your attitude? Preaching is the gift of God. The attitude that you're having. You sleep while the king is talking to you. You are in need of a blessing, but you're sleeping. Instead of fighting with this demon of sleepiness, you are fighting with the preacher saying, let him finish. We want to go home. See that attitude? You have to fight with the sleepiness. Say, release me. I want to listen. I want to receive a blessing. But you are busy having a small prayer in your heart. And you know, must. Your mom is going to complain. You must finish. You want to go home. You must finish. You people talk with their hearts. You know that?
Yeah.
They talk. Why? It's too long. We can't finish. We want to go home. I'm touching some of you, right?
Amen.
I'm also touching myself. Not the word of no respect of persons.
Amen.
When the preacher is preaching here, he's not just preaching to you, he's also preaching to himself.
Yeah.
It's God talking.
Amen.
And the prophet says, watch them on a platform sometimes in healing services. You know, there are a lot of people, we come for prayer lines, we've got issues, we've got sicknesses. And other needs. He said, watch them when they come. What is the attitude that they come in? That attitude that you come in. Here the other night I was, remember the lady come up there with just about enough. Why didn't have enough faith hardly to get to the platform? No faith. She had been in prayer, line after prayer line. No, we have done that. We have been in prayer line. You have been praying for today. You have been praying for tomorrow. You have been praying for. You have been praying for. You are coming. What's wrong? God still answers prayer. We change men. The man of God comes. Another one you needed to be praying for the same thing. Another one comes. You want to be praying for the same thing. What is the problem? The problem is with me. Because once your attitude is right, God will grant your desire.
Amen.
God answers prayer. He does answer prayer. Always. He said, I know that the woman wasn't going to get well. He's coming for prayer to the prophet of God. But here the prophet is looking at her and says, this one is not going to get well. You see, it's not the prophet, it's not the man of God that does the miraculous. It is the faith that we have with the man of God that does the miraculous. It is the faith that we have to the man that's preaching to you that does the miracle in you and for you.
Amen.
So sometimes you say, we need a powerful man of God. We need powerful believers, not powerful men of God. So I said, I knew that is going to get well. She can't do it, I said. The Lord Jesus bless you. He said, now the sister had come to the platform. And here the prophet said, the Lord bless you, sister. Go, may he heal you. It's all I could say. He's pronouncing a blessing. Yet he knows that there's nothing good could happen here. She had been here and there and everywhere. You see? They were like that. You can't do that. You got to take God at his word. Here a few weeks ago, a man came up to me and said, Brother Branham said, I went out and I tried a free man. He's a minister. He couldn't do me any good. He was going to prayer lines. He got a free man. I went to Osborne, Brother Osborne. He couldn't do me any good. And I went to Oakville, and he couldn't do me any good. I went to Roberts. Now I have come to you. He's still looking for an answer from God. He has gone to men of God, prayer after prayer. Now I said, you are going to go. The prophet now, he said to this man, I said, you are going away the same way. You went to all our robbers, you couldn't get the blessing that you were looking for. You went to all these other ministers, and you have come to me now, you are going to go away the same way, with nothing. When you thought, now I've come to the real powerful man of God, a messenger, now the messenger is saying, you are going to go the same way. You are not going to get nothing. That's right, I said, you are going to the wrong person. Go to God, not some man.
Amen.
Most of the time, you want a man. You want brother so-and-so to come, one brother so-and-so to come, one brother so. You are going to the wrong person, you must go to God.
Amen.
When we are talking about God, now it's a personal affair now. You don't need the pastor then. You don't need the brother Opius, don't need brother Vincent, you don't need the pastor or any minister. You don't need a mama there. You don't need a son. You don't need anybody. It's you and God. It's not personal.
Amen.
He has been in prayer lines. Go went to powerful men of God, but he couldn't get anything. He said, you are going to the wrong person.
How many of us are looking for something? They've been praying in their life. They're looking for something. If they're hoping to meet a man that would help them grant their heart desires, God will grant their heart desires.
But I say to you, as the prophet is saying, you're going to the wrong person. And you keep going, and you will die in that situation. Why? Because you're going to the wrong person. What can we do? Nothing. This man, men cannot do anything. It's him that's already done it. It's a finished work at Calvary. Just believe his word and accept it. You see how simple it is? Just believe his word and accept it. It will take place. But until then, it won't do you any bit of good. Until you believe and accept. No matter where you go, this is the message that we believe he is also speaking to you. No matter where you are going to go, if you have a need in your heart, if you have a sickness, if you have a challenge that you are having, no matter where you are going, you are going to go come back the same way. You won't get anything. Until you believe and accept him in that simple manner. There's a song that says, only believe, all things are possible. Only believe, all things are possible. Even the Bible says, pray one for another. Believe that prayer. When you have a challenge, there's a sister next door or somewhere close or on the phone. Get it together. Just pray and believe that prayer. Something will happen. Amen. You don't need the pastor to come over. You need that sister, the next person. Even yourself. It can happen. It's just your attitude. But until then, it won't do you a bit of good. No matter where you go, you are going to go away from here just as disappointed as you went away from the other places. Because your heart isn't right with God. You see, he was going to find a man that could help him with this situation. A man of God. And he said, your heart is not right. Just by that attitude of going looking for a man of God, he said, your heart is not right. So when you are looking for a man, a powerful man of God, that's not the right attitude. Your heart is not right. Because God does not share any glory with anybody. Amen. I don't say it was an immoral act now. He said, it's not a sin. You see, when he says your heart is not right, he's not talking about that thing. You're doing sin. No. It's not about sin. It's not about something that you've done wrong somewhere. Just by that attitude of looking for men of God, going around looking for men of God. He said, that's a wrong attitude. And that is it. You are not right in your heart. This is what we do most of the time. But they say, that's not right. You can't believe. That's true. He went away the same way. You see, he had been to all these great powerful men of God. But when he came to the prophet, he still went away the same way. Why? Because his attitude was very wrong. He was looking for a powerful man of God. Instead of looking unto God. So that's what we need. We need people that understand who they are and know that God is the one that holds my blessings. So you go to him in faith and he will grant it unto you. When you sing, let's sing with faith. Oh, this was a powerful message, brother. God bless you very much. How many have been challenged this morning? It's a challenge. We have to adjust many things. The Bible says, you ask. You don't have because you don't ask. And if you do ask and still don't have, it's because you are asking wrong. You see? In other words, you are praying, but you are praying wrong. Something's wrong with your prayer.
impossible for you to ask and not have. But you have been asking but still you don't have. Why? Your prayer is not right somewhere. So let's ask right. Let's approach God the right way and pray the right way, and God will grant our heart desires. I believe. Sister Malika, give us that song. If you believe in your heart, believe now. He is still God. It's not too late. It's never too late for God. He's always on time. He's just waiting for you to be positioned right. Once your position is right in Him, you will have whatever the need is. Hallelujah.
Moyo waka urie, urie, urie. Moyo waka urie, urie, urie. Moyo waka,
waka urie, urie,
urie,
urie.
With it. May we see you every time when you speak to us, Lord. When we are walking along the road, may we see you in your nature. When you are at work, Lord, whatever will be happening around us, may we recognize you each time, Lord. Because you promise you'll never leave us, you'll never forsake us. You shall be with us until the very end. And we know that you are always with us. Many times when you face challenges, it might be sickness, it might be hunger, it might be marital challenges, whatever the situation is that we'll be facing, we tend to forget that you are still with us, Lord. We tend to run and look far away. We're looking for a man that can help us. Why you are right there with us, Lord? Forgive us. That's a wrong attitude. We forget that you are always with us, Almighty God. We don't need another man from somewhere. If he comes, it's all right. But you're always with us, Lord. May we tend to you, Father, like Jonah, who was the one in the world, hope of the well. He knew that wherever he is, God is there. He turned around and faced to the where the trouble was, and he prayed a prayer of faith that you visited him there. You turned around the ship, the well, and you brought him to where he was supposed to go and vomited. You are still the same God today. Many times we expect things in our imaginations. When we are praying for, we don't believe enough. Sometimes the prayer might be so simple, so short, and we think that it's not powerful enough. Oh, it's a wrong attitude, Lord. We feel that if we can be prayed for by a man that can jump and scream and do many things, then the prayer can be heard. But we forget that you are a God of humility, a God in simplicity. You can come and go without anyone noticing you here. Only those that are in the spirit can catch and see you. Help us, Father, as your church. Help us to have the right mental attitude every time. Help us to have winning spirits to serve you every time. Because we have to serve one another as we serve you, Almighty God. Now we not complain and murmur each time, that you may be pleased with us, Almighty God. Oh, Jesus, we love you. Forgive us all those iniquities. Forgive us of all those sins and transgressions. Forgive us of all that we have wronged you. Because we love you, Father. Time is fast spent. One of this morning, Lord, it shall happen. But are we ready? Are we washed in the blood of the Lamb? We will meet you, Lord. It's a big question that you always ask yourself. Am I ready to face you? What do I bring to you when I meet you? What is it that I've done that I can present to you, Lord? I say, Lord, you've given me these three gifts, but I have money to get these trophies out of them. Of that which you have given us, Lord, how much have I gained to present to you that you can say, well done, my good and faithful servant? Remember us now, Lord, we ask. Sister, brother, we are all your servants, Lord, we have to serve you. Remember us. Now we be in service day and night, meditating upon your word day and night, praying prayer day and night. The Bible says, pray without ceasing. For the days are dangerous, days are dark. Gross darkness is upon the people, it's upon this world. We need more of your grace, Lord, now. We can hardly stay in church 30 minutes. We can hardly stay in church 1 hour. Help us, Father, to love to be in your presence. Bring us that spirit, Father, that we may love to be in your presence. We may love to worship you. We may love to dance for you. We may love to clap our hands unto you. We may sing with all our hearts and pray with all our hearts and love one another above everything. Help us now, Father, we pray. Thank you, Father, for reminding us that this power that we have is enough to defeat the enemy. And we must go with this, our power that you have given unto us. And we must go with the right mental attitude, because it will always bring your blessings to us, and every desire will come to pass. Grant it to Almighty God, we ask, as we have come to the end of this service, Almighty God. Touch each and everyone now. As we are going out, Lord Jesus, may we go meditating upon this. May we go thinking upon this and say, Lord, I've been wrong. I've been looking at the wrong things. I've been looking forward to men that can help me while you're with me. Just like the servant of Elisha, when the Syrians were camped around them and they couldn't see you, they cried and one stressed and said, oh my Lord, we are finished. What are we going to do? But because the man of God was there, who would tap into the spirit, who knows who you are, who knows your promises, and says, Lord, open his eyes, let him see. And when you opened his eyes, he could see a band of angels with the chariots and horses of fire around the mountain. Men are they that are with us than those that are against us. Greater is he that is in us than the one that is fighting against us. Help us, Father, we pray. May we always remember that in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.